Biohacker Season 2 had a mysterious ending, but considering clues that were dropped throughout the season, we know who did it and why. And it was a payoff to three specific conversations over the course of the season. On top of that, there's a very dark takeaway that I missed until I rewatched the season today, so I'd like to share that, but first, let's do a high-level recap of Biohackers Season 2. As a reminder, Season 1 of Biohackers ended with Mia and Lawrence being kidnapped by Andreas Winter after Mia gave Andreas data to expose Lawrence for her unethical Homo Deus project. The opening scene of Biohacker Season 2 takes place 3 months later. Mia woke up while sitting in front of a test that she was doing about a hamster's memory. That memory experiment was a nod to Mia's own memory arc over the course of the season. Mia's journey was about finding out what had happened to her and why she was dying. Here's what really happened. Lada's father had financed Lawrence, but he did not like the Homo Deus project. Wolfgang von Furstenberg feared that if every child was immune from disease, then humans would overpopulate the world. So he exposed Lawrence to the authorities. But he dealt with Mia differently. First, they texted her friends and told them that she would be quarantined for 3 days on back of the mosquito train incident from season 1. Then, instead of killing Mia, since she knew too much about Homo Deus, Mia volunteered to be given one of his other experimental drugs, Oblivion, which erases one's memory. So she did that. Andreas Winter experimented on her. Then, she went back to her friends and partied a lot. So her friends would chalk up her periodic blackouts to her partying. Nicholas broke up with her. She hooked up with Lada's brother Uli at some point, and then she began dating Jasper again after he got back from Indonesia, where Lada had helped him escape to, and where he was trying to figure out how to cure his Huntington's disease. After 3 months, something changed. Mia forgot about everything that had happened over those 3 months. That was the opening scene. She woke up at her desk confused. Then, she started having flashbacks of a conversation at the park and being captive in a van with Lawrence. So she met up with Lawrence, who told Mia that Wolfgang kept notes in a red notebook. Lawrence tried to help Mia to find that notebook at first out of self-interest, because Lawrence would be able to leverage what was in that notebook so as to expose Wolfgang for his other unethical projects that he was financing, and effectively buy herself freedom since she was currently being prosecuted for Homo Deus. But eventually, for several reasons, Lawrence came to care for Mia. She began to look at Mia as the daughter whom she never had. They figured out that the way to reverse the effects of Oblivion was neuronal sonification. The tattoo clue, S-O-N, for sonification. Lawrence saved Mia's life. Mia got back all her memories, but when she woke up, all of her friends were prisoners to Wolfgang and Lada. Mia ran from Wolfgang. Nicholas freed Jasper. Jasper saved Mia from Wolfgang. Then Mia tackled Wolfgang over a balcony, and he was hospitalized. At the hospital, Wolfgang told Lada that he needed her to do something, which we will get back to. In the second to last scene of season 2, Mia visited Lawrence at a children's graveyard. That graveyard was where Lawrence's life trajectory had begun. As a student, that children's graveyard had broken her. That children's graveyard was why Lawrence became who she became and why she did what she did, which was some pretty dark stuff, but ultimately for a great purpose. Lawrence's lifelong goal was to never let another child die from disease. And for Lawrence, the ends justified the means. In poetic fashion, Lawrence was shot at the very children's graveyard where her life of discovery had begun. Technically, we do not know for sure that she died, but considering the location, it would be the perfect spot for her to pass the torch on to her child of sorts, Mia Ackerland. So the big question is, who did it? Who shot Lawrence? Well, Lada's father had told her that he needed her to do something for him. Considering the fact that Lada's brother had told Mia earlier in the season that Lada was the best shooter in the family, other than their father, who was in a hospital bed at the time, all signs point to Lada. Lada shot Lawrence. And it makes sense. Lada had three specific discussions around the ends justifying the means. At first, Lada argued against that theory in a discussion with Nicholas. But then, Lada's brother reminded her that she had helped Jasper, who was a fugitive, escape to Indonesia to do Huntington's disease research. In other words, Lada had practiced the theory that the ends justifies the means by helping Jasper escape the country. Then, in this scene here, Lada suggested that she had a change of opinion on the matter. So Wolfgang told Lotta that he needed her to do something for him, and she was stated to be the best shooter in the family other than her father, which means Lotta most likely shot Lawrence under the premise that the ends justifies the means. But there was more to it than just that. Right before she was shot, Lawrence asked Mia why she wanted to meet there, and Mia was like, "What? You asked me to meet here." In other words, Lotta didn't just kill Lawrence. She wanted Mia to see Lawrence die. Let that sink in. But there is a silver lining. In the final scene, Mia threw away the necklace of her middle name, Mia, suggesting that Mia is going to finally embrace the entire truth. She is not Mia. She is Emma Mia Ackerland. And Emma Ackerland is literally the embodiment of Lawrence's lifetime of work. So there's a good chance that Emma picks up where Lawrence left off in season 3. Emma will try to bring Homo Deus to the world so as to prevent children from dying of disease and, if possible, curing Jasper of Huntington's disease as well. Another great season. Can't wait for part 3.